Jade Young was a mum of two daughters murdered while doing the most ordinary thing in the world, going shopping. She was one of the six people killed in the Bondi stabbings. Tonight, in this project exclusive, Jade's courageous mum is demanding answers over her daughter's death.
Just an ordinary day. Just a beautiful sunny autumn day. I don't think Jade knew what hit her. We believe that anyway.
We begin with breaking news out of the Westfield shopping centre in Sydney's Bondi Junction.
Six people were murdered and 12 injured by a man armed with a knife.
Police say a man attacked several people at the Westfield in Bondi Junction.
Elizabeth Young is racked with grief and anger, struggling to understand why her daughter Jade was ripped away from her on that Saturday in the most senseless and violent of circumstances.
Such an ordinary place full of other mothers, children and people shopping and just enjoying the space, expecting that they would be secure and safe. It was the most dangerous place in the world for six people.
Jade had ducked into the shops with her young daughter to grab a birthday present. She never made it home.
I heard from another room my husband scream out something. And he came to the door and said, "Jade's dead." And life changed.
Tell me about Jade.
Very soft-hearted. Very soft-hearted. There was nothing that she wouldn't do for the girls. And my last memory of her is we would take her ridiculous schnoodle puppy up to the Royal Hotel in Randwick and we would have a family meal and Jade would carry the pup up in a handbag. She loved that little dog.
When something like that happens, I mean, did you believe it straight away?
No, of course not. I still don't believe it. I have moments when I'm just doing something mechanically, hanging the washing out or doing the dishes or doing something like that, and I forget. And then there's a wave sweeps over me and I have an image of her lying at rest in the viewing room at the coroner's court. And that is an image that will stay with me for the rest of my life.
Her girls are so young.
Yes.
I can't imagine how they're processing everything.
They have talked and we are so close that we can talk, but this is how we're managing the five L's in life. The love of family and friends, the licks from Teddy the schnoodle puppy, the lasagna that Andrew and others have made for us, lollies, and Lego.
The catastrophic event has shone a light on the country's mental health system. The killer's parents say their son was diagnosed with schizophrenia when he was 17. He reportedly stopped his treatment 5 years ago. A coronial inquiry will focus on his mental state at the time and in the months leading up to the attack.
It appears that there were red flags that he was a very troubled man, that police had been involved with him, and it's not the fault of the police, but this whole system, I suppose. He was known to collect knives, and yet he was off his medication, and he came down into New South Wales. My daughter's dead now.
What do you want to say to politicians?
They must take action. We need more practitioners in the mental health system. We need facilities to care for people who are troubled. They should, in my opinion, and this is from a very distressed woman, they should be governed much more closely than they are. No person who is showing these sorts of signs should be able to persuade a doctor to reduce his medication.
Police believe the killer was targeting women. Aussie leaders are meeting tomorrow for crisis talks on men's violence against women after mass marches on the weekend.
It's not just government's problem. It's a problem of our entire society. And this is a national crisis.
This has been so shocking. Six people were killed by a man with a very large knife in a seemingly very secure, happy, ordinary area. So this is the moment, because we really do need to change.
I think part of the anger that we saw at the rallies all around the country is that we've been here before.
Absolutely.
And it holds the nation's attention for a moment.
Yes.
You've said during Jade's memorial that you really want Australia to listen.
Yes.
What do you want the country to hear the most?
We have to have a complete cultural change. Men have to acknowledge that muscles and aggression are not necessary anymore. Men need to look within themselves. Mothers need to raise their sons in a different way. Fathers need to actually parent and raise their sons to respect women.
The Prime Minister tweeted, "Enough is enough."
Yes.
What do you say to that?
Do it. Support the families who are grieving, and then go about seriously improving the situation with mental health.
You're a grandmother and you just got your first tattoo.
Yes.
What drove you to get that?
My son, Peter, said to me, "Mum, I'm getting a tattoo." So am I. I wanted mine there, so it's out there. Beautiful Jade, but yes, she's always with me.
Wow, you see the mother and you realise what a loss that daughter is to the world, to Australia, to her family and everybody who knew her. What a gracious woman, what a wise woman. But it feels like it just ends up people talking.
Yeah. I'm not sure about that last bit, actually.
I hope not.
Yeah, obviously. But, like, tragedies are horrible to go through, but they do give it opportunity so that in the long run, like, they sound a bell, or they ring a bell, and in the long run it's possible lives will be saved because of the responses that we choose to undertake. Now, it's entirely possible not. I grant you, I'm not going to be Pollyanna-ish about this, but it's possible. And I would have to say, and I hope I'm not being naive, I would have to say I've heard things in the responses that I haven't heard before.
Like even the professor we had on tonight who was specifically mentioning pornography that I find mainly absent from all these conversations about male anger and aggression and violence towards women.
And even she referred to male aggression and so on. But it's the detail, it's the flesh that's being put on those bones. I don't want to be... I want to be cautious. Like, I don't want to be promising anything. It's not for me to do, obviously. But that's the test, right? That's it's what you do with the moment. Not for her. She's got that grief and there is nothing that will... bring Jade back.
That's also why Elizabeth wanted to stand up. I mean, it's still so raw for her to be speaking, but she's like, it can't just be a moment that this holds the nation's attention. Change needs to come from it.
Yeah, and I guess we watch and we see. Right? And then we speak about it, we agitate, if need be.
And we do.
We do. And those who can do, at the very least, have the power to, A GoFundMe page has been set up, by the way, to support Jade's two young daughters. If you would like to donate, head to our website for the details.